beginning. There is nothing. Just a space of desolation, emptiness, and an endless stretch of dark. How strange, then, that here, through a series of hapless chances, a new thing breathed life. Pure, untouched, unknowing, the world was born to its maker, and cradled in her loving arms, the world awoke into the darkness. Together they kept a vigil in the silent void, enamored by each other's presence. The world clutched, helpless, fretting the cold, the emptiness, and the stray voices that called out from over the limitless void. Unbeknown to the Maker and her child, another thing stalked the void. It crept across the vastness of black, pacing ghostly footsteps through the barren dirt. It was the Shadow. Inside it grew a hatred so cataclysmic that it turned every aching breath into a blistering cold wind that scorched the newborn skin around. So young and so delicate, the world could only clutch onto its mother and weep against the afflicting cold. The icy air twisted like wicked thorns inside its tender lungs, and still, the Shadow circled closer, driven to complete its woeful destiny, driven to consume and destroy everything else that dared to share.
To hear us, we beseech you, to hear us, it is I, the firstborn.
The Maker despaired, embracing her weakening child that drifted further and further away into an eternity of sleep. But no matter how much she tried, the world breathed slower and slower. In chorus with the Maker's sobs and urgent whispers to the ailing world, the Shadow cackled and soaked up the glory of her grief.
You hear us now, the first here and the last here. Alone, dear.
Then, amidst the overwhelming clouded air of death that soared over them, a small spark of hope willed itself into life. Beneath the decaying flesh of the still and lifeless world, a river of light began to flow. It coursed through its blackened veins, and the Maker watched on, overcome. She saw the light fill where the ebbed tide of blood once flowed, until the world was enveloped in a pure white light, until the world opened its eyes and breathed once more. The Shadow heard its voice, and with wide, stunned eyes turned to look. It was the light, so pure, so graceful, so filled with hope. It breathed, and the darkness dissipated. It spread its wings and broke the spell of death and decay. It sang, and the shadow was shaken. It fell to its knees. Spring began in the land that had once only known a thousand winters, and the shadow could not bear it.
From the same dust, from the same breath, you are their god, and I their death. Your reign has begun.
With a powerful roar, the shadow rose into the air, taking in the expansive view of his now changing domain. And then he fell, down, 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 with only the last stretch of his precious void to cushion the fall. Cracks scattered across the landscape, and the Maker and the Light watched as the tide rose up from the chasm that he left. Shadow had splintered into thousands of soldiers, and they charged towards the light, filled with an unfathomable hatred.
The first, the last.
The light rose its wings into the air, and more golden rays of light fell to the barren ground to make new life. But with every space restored, the shadow soldiers reclaimed a dozen more. Traversed the beauteous land and filled it with their envy and disdain. They tore it down and left a massacre in their wake. Hope turned to despair. Calm turned to chaos. Purity faded to gloom. And with every passing day, they grew closer and closer to the light that stood its ground. Debilitated, despair. spring turned winter. The shadow soldiers charged off, unshaken, undeterred, and with the light, they collided. A vast and blinding light swept across the void, and smoke rose to choke the air. For an eon, the space rattled and shifted. For an eternity, voices screamed in agony. For what must have been forever, the Maker waited, till the last of her hope threatened to abandon her. Then, as the sounds faded and the earth ceased to shake, the Maker opened her tired, forlorn eyes to look. Here, in the dark and listless void, the dust settled, the air cleared, and a new thing breathed life.